This thing I'm about to show you, I have a love-hate relationship with it. It's called UAC. You might already know it. UAC, or user account control. I don't like being controlled, but I also love it because it helps keep my users safe. You've probably seen it before, right? Check this out. Here in Windows, go ahead and launch your Windows, by the way. If I were to launch my terminal, and I want to do this as an administrator with elevated permissions, godlike control. Right click, run as administrator. Boom, I'm hit with this. This can be quite annoying, but it can also save your computer. Now notice me, as an administrator of the system, I'm simply prompted with a yes or no, meaning I have permissions to do whatever I want, but it's a bit of a precaution, like, are you sure? And what this does is actually pretty cool, because if you're learning to become a hacker or you're wanting to avoid being hacked, this is a pretty good protection from hackers. You'll probably notice that if you ever use the remote desktop protocol, or what people use, it has a timer. Check that out, that's pretty cool. Come back up, I wasn't done with you yet. When you're trying to remotely access your system, meaning you're at another computer, maybe your phone, and you're trying to log into this computer, if you hit a situation where UAC pops up, a lot of the time, you don't see the prompt as the remote person. So you can't proceed. It just times out, disappears, and you can't do what you want to do. So when a potential hacker tries to hack you, they can't elevate those permissions. So that's pretty killer. But this is what I see as an admin. Now if I click yes, I'm good to go. There it goes. But let's try the same thing with a normal user account. So real quick, let's add a new user with the skills we learned in previous videos. I'm gonna launch Terminal as an administrator. We're gonna do this via command line, because it's really fast. We'll set a password for our new user with the password variable, having equal read host, saying we want this to be a secure string. I'll just make it password, and then we'll create our new user. New local, I can't type today. Local user, name, Abby, password, user created. Now, by default, when a user is created like this, as you may recall from previous video, they're a standard user. They don't have admin permissions. Let's demonstrate. So if you created a user like this, I hope you did. Let's go ahead and log out and log in as this user. We can right click our start button, shut down or sign out, and we want to sign out. Click in here to sign in. And now we're gonna log in as, where's my new user account? Why isn't it working? All right, let's log back in as us and we'll just do a restart. Maybe it needs time to think. There's Abby. Let's take a look inside her account. Maybe she doesn't have permissions. Let's go to member of, yep, there it is. You need to be part of the members group. I'm sorry, part of the users group to be able to use this computer. Kind of makes sense, right? Okay, we figured it out. Dumb mistake, right? Now let's sign out. There's Abby. Password. Okay, so now I'm logged in as Abby. If I try to do that same thing we did before, launching terminal as an administrator, boom. Okay, this is no longer a simple yes or no question. It's saying, hey, you need an administrator password because you're not an admin. You don't have these privileges. So think about that. You got your standard user, maybe they get hacked. Even if the hacker does have their account and they're logged in as them, they can't do much. They can't do what's called privilege escalation because it's blocked by UAC. I would have to know some administrator account to log in. And I could do that. So like for my daughters right now, I do have UAC for them. They don't have admin rights. So whenever they want to install something or do something with admin privileges, they have to say, Dad, come log in. So I'll come over there and just for that moment, give it my password to do what they want to do. But when they try to do it again, bam, they need permission. It's a great way to control access and prevent your users from doing something dumb. Now let's log out of Abby and log back in as our admin account. Now you can change the behavior of user account control. If we go to our search bar and search for user account, and there it is, change user account controls, the very top, we'll click on that. And here we have levels of control. And this is basically choosing when to be notified about changes to your computer. Because if you've seen any of my other hacking videos, most of them involve first trying to disable UAC because you can't do much. So by default, we're right here. Notify me only when apps try to make changes to my computer. If we take it a step further, extreme security, we've got one more added level. Even when I try to make a Windows setting change, block me. Well, at least prompt me and block all the other users. Now, it's not the default setting for a reason because it's quite annoying. So I'll never do that. But let's take a look at the lower levels with the bottom rung being, yeah, don't even turn on UAC. So if you look at level, I guess one, and this one seems kind of vague because it's like, hey, it looks the same. Notify me when apps try to make changes to my computer, but don't dim my desktop. What does that mean? Well, let's try it out. Let's okay that, which will also be a UAC prompt. We'll launch terminal as administrator. And it's just one small difference, right? I guess you're thinking, man, dimming it is so much more intrusive. I like the dim. Let's get back to UAC, which by the way, you can just search for UAC. Now, I do want to point out something too. Notice on the okay button, if I were to okay any of these changes, we've got a Windows Defender looking shield. Whenever you see that on an option, you know you're going to be prompted with a UAC. Now let's get down to the bottom rung, which is the worst. Never notify. We're essentially disabling UAC, so I'll go ahead and make that change. Our last UAC prompt, yes. So now when we try to launch Terminal as administrator, good to go. Now just so you know, me changing this here is just for me. It's not computer wide. So if I log back in as Abby, with this setting still intact, let's just say cancel, let's go sign out. And I launch UAC as Abby. First of all, I can't even see it. So I have to log in as an admin. And then look, the default behavior is still the same for Abby. And watch this. If Abby tries to change this, I don't know why this is freaking out. Bam, it's like, hey, you gotta be logged in as an admin on this computer to select this setting. So essentially, if you want to disable UAC, you have to be an admin for your account. And that's UAC. Annoying, but definitely needed in our current landscape. I'll see you in the next episode.
Oh, hey, I didn't see you there. For more IT courses just like this one, go to academy.networkchuck.com. Link in the description.